Hey, good evening, everyone. So far, I basically signed in here early. So before I do anything, let me pray my traitor's prayer. Father God, as you promised in your word in James chapter 1, verse 5, if we ask for any discernment or wisdom, divine wisdom, you will not rebuke us. So therefore, I come to you, Lord, to ask in prayer for your divine wisdom and discernment in my trading today as I utilize these charts. May my winds, may you lead me to the correct decisions and give me the grace to control my emotions. May my wins humble me and my losses teach me valuable lessons. May I serve you as an inspiration to others and be able to give back your blessings to those who are in need, and most of all, to glorify your name and your kingdom, Lord. This is not about me. It's all about you, Lord, and your kingdom. So therefore, all this I ask in the name of your Son, my Savior and my Lord, Jesus Christ. Amen. So I got a trade here. I had to reset my settings here because of my MNQ, and I'm trading MNQ right now. So based on this Fibonacci right off the retracement right to the 50%. Now it's getting up to here. I'm just seeing more of a pullback where I can get a trade here. And it looks like I'm
order submitted.
Getting that pullback right now. Now let's see how far this is going to go back. If it's going to go back all the way here to test this VWAP, let's see. So I'll leave it here for a minute. Or will this go back up? So you see there's a high momentum bar going up there. Again, let's see if that's going to continue going up. If it does, then I'll take it right here. You know that. So let me do this. We do another buy stop here. If it hits that, that's fine. If it doesn't, then we try to get down here. I was able to get this order here. In fact, if I can see my trade performance right here. I had an earlier trade on ES, which I've made on another account. So I'm basically up right now in that account. I'll just leave it like that. So there we got this one. Let's see this.
Order canceled.
Okay, so that's my thing. So basically, I think that's 25. How many points is that? See, there's a lot of there. See, this might get stopped. Let's see what's going to get stopped out here. A lot of slippage right now. Let me see here. 14. Let's see if this is going to maintain this at least. My stop loss is around 15 points. Let's see if it's going to push this up or let's bank down here. I want to bring this down maybe.
Yep.
And push it down further. At least that's 15 points. Is that? See, at least I only risk that. Now it's going to maybe get down here to the VWAP. It's going to test that VWAP. It's testing this RTH of VWAP right now. So let's see if we can get a move up here. Yep, there it is. Sometimes when you
order submitted,
seeing my stop wasn't wide enough, but that's okay. So as I was saying, let's go back to trade performance since now I got it lost there. So here's the thing. So you see, I was up as 363. This one I got lost 126. I'm down to 237. Not much of a loss. You know what? I got to start putting my on this one ETF, which is basically this one. I want to set my commissions on the ETF, which is that. So there. So now we're going up here. I missed this. Let's see if we can get a pullback on this trade. I'm trading my performance account, so this is a live account, so a funded account. So I'm doing a funded account. This is where I'm at. So let's do this. Which is this one. So I'm down $22. That's basically what it is. And then some commission, whatever it is. Not that much. Not that significant. I was up as much as 104. So again, my goal here is to make it around 200, either 200, 300, which is fine with me. Again, with micros, you don't have to be seeing that much. So I have four contracts I'm trading on micro NQ, and it looks like we are seeing this test up here. I'm basing on deviation levels, so. I'm not quite pulling back to my pending order there. Yeah, but I don't want to be chasing this, so I'll just leave it like that. So eventually going to get back to the mid band, so. So there's the opening, so can't really get into that. Let me see if I can get a, I'll be just on my performance account here, the funded account. I'll just be strictly trading micros. I don't want to be trading ES, especially it's only a $50,000 account until I start building up my profits maybe. But right now my goal is to slowly build up my funded account here in profit. You can see this is going up. Very good trade here in the beginning, which I was busy doing. What was I doing? And I should have taken this right here. And sometimes you get distracted. See, this one would have been a good one. Again, just reiterating this pullback right there. Most likely it's going to get back up here. There is a confluence of the two targets, right? Of the profit targets. Good trade. It would have been a good entry right here. Good points. It would have been done for the day. So, like I said, I'm not going to sit there and try to chase that trade. Let another opportunity present itself. I want to see a pullback. once it hits that, maybe that profit target up there, the extension, and then come back, which we'll see. Just be patient, that's all. Okay. Wonder if they're in the right trade room here. Webinar ID is 4, what is this? 435. Which one is this? Maybe, hold on. Let me go to the other webinar. Okay, let me go see if I got that right. Hold on. Hey, Sir June. So I don't know, I mentioned I must have been in a different webinar, but anyways, I was trading my performance account here, the funded account. And what I'm doing is I made a commitment that I'll be trading strictly micros on this until I build it up even more, and I'll eventually trade the ES, because right now the ES is kind of let me check how it's running right now. Just really weird the way it's running. If it's running pretty decent, then maybe I might look at it. But before, in fact, I did use another evaluation account that overnight session, which I've hit my profit goal over 200 bucks. So I was done with the ES. Again, I usually trade it during the overnight session. So right now I got an entry here in my, my Markios, which is basically like I showed here, I had a loss, but it's not significant. And see here, I had a win and then I gave it back. Basically, my only loss right now is 22 bucks. I'm trading 4 contracts on micros and I'm looking for this to maybe pull back to some and then come back here and probably hit the extensions here. But we'll see. Hopefully that's what it does rather than continue and hit it. So we're just waiting for a good opportunity here. And so people are asking me usually what's my settings on my micros. So this is what it is. In ticks, I'm looking at 60 tick loss or 15 points. Now, if I can just do this maybe in terms of points, that would be usually... Here, if I do this in points, price, maybe that's what it is, price. So, no, I haven't ticks. It's nearly on ticks. So 60 ticks is basically 15 points, I believe. Yeah, 15 points. My first target is 50 points as well. This is 15.15. This is 50 points, the first target, and... No, 25 points and then 50 points the second target. So here we have a good pull up right here. So you can get something here. Again, there's some, I think there's some slippage here. Like right now, it's freezing up. But that's okay, because on micros, you don't, it's fine. You don't risk that much. But again, my profit goes around 200 to 300. And you do that consistently, you'll be fine. So let's see if we have an opportunity here. If it does pull back to where my pending order is, then that's fine. But I'm not going to chase it if it pulls back again, and this is based on the deviation levels. I mean, you didn't quite pull back to this deviation level right here. But it was a pullback nonetheless. So right here, like for example, it didn't pull back to this deviation. And now it filled my, at least it filled me. Let's see if it's going to, see what's going to happen here. If it's going to stop me, I got a 15-point stop. So was, you see this. We're below the price, but we're above. You see this? That's why we have slippage. It's going to be right at the extension, which is good. And this is basically 25 points here. The first target is 25 points. The second target is what, 50, I believe, which is basically 100 bucks. So this is 50 bucks each. There we go. On the, on three, so that's what, 100, 150. And if it's this, let me see what that is to be exact. Hopefully that's 50. Let me get my pen out of here. Might be too late. So 50, that'd be at least, what is that, 401? I want to get at least 50. So that should be 413.50. Okay, right around there. A little over. That's fine. See, here's the number of points. So if I can get 50 points out of that, that's 100 bucks there again. So, and that's only one contract. Again, hit our extension. But let's see how far we can ride this. So we can ride this to another 50 points for another 100 bucks. I'd be happy. Let's pull up our trailing drawdown here. How far do we want to go? This would be too tight up there. So let's maybe get a maybe break even here. That's fine. You see around right here. So you can get 50 points out of this one. So let's see our, so there, 50, 50, 50. So I'm not bet 126. And if this hits that, that'd be another 100, that'd be around 226. Like I said, the reason I'm trading NQ, it's less, MNQ, not NQ. MNQ, it's less too stressful, less risk, and it moves pretty good. Rather compared to ES. ES right now is really, during the morning session is more erratic. I mean, for me, I mean, I can pick some levels there, maybe I can, but the risk is too much right now. Like for example, it's not that bad, it's 10 points, the band spread on ES. So now I created a nice swing here so we can bring up our right here. Filling stopped there. That's fine. Not quite made, was close to making it, but it didn't make it. Let's see if we can get another shot at this. So let's see here. We have the pullback. And there's a second try getting this one. And we're seeing something draw this out now since the extend this out. So maybe right here. And then hit the target. Came back to the high point there.
stop, Bill.
Man, finally stopped me out. Several tries to get up to that 50. So if you look at now my total profit is 161. If we look at my Rhythmic Trader, I'm at 153.26. So that's fine. Slowly work it. Work for another opportunity here. Gonna see if it's gonna pull back here, at least to the zones there. Let's see what's this overall one right here is. Pullback came all the way back up there. That's fine. So we have a pullback there. This is that other Fibonacci. I'm more into looking into the from the overnight session. So let's see. If there's any confluence in these zones, see, get up here. This one I can take out. Looks like it's going up, right? We never really got that pullback all here. So now there would have been your 50 points. I could have just left it at break even. I would have got my 50 points or another $100 there, which should have been. Sometimes I have put my stop way too tight. I just sort of let it just come back, especially the way M and Q run. See, my entry was down here, right? So I could have just had my entry, my break even right here, my stop. I would have got my 50 points. That would have been another $100. Rather than a, what I got it, it's $30, I think. Yeah, $34, so we got another $100. That made a big, good difference here. So now we're going above here. Really, pullback is right here, that's about it, but let's see if we can get this.
Order to order, Phil.
Again, if I'm looking at this, we're going off this deviation. Oh, looks like we're gonna give some back here. Look at that. That just came back down. Again, my risk is around 15 points. Let's see if we can just, I want to control my risk. That's the reason why. I can have it all the way down here, but that's too much of a risk for me.
Stop, Bill.
So there's my 15 points. That's fine.
Order submitted.
and I tried to move it. Look how fast that moved. I was trying to get it up, trying to get up to here, the 200 level, where if it hit that, that would have been 400 bucks trade. But again, it hit this one at 25 points at least, so maybe I got maybe. I'm at 177. So if it hits this one, I'll be at 277. So here, I'll bring this up to break even. There.
Stop, Phil.
So this break even, I'm at 179. It lost there, so at 180. Well, see the they didn't get the commissions here. All in all, it's 179.10. That's what my profit is. Again, pulling down to the the retracement, that's which I would expect since we didn't really pull down there. In the meantime, I'm also keeping my eye on the ES. Again, they have a lot of erratic moves on that, so that's why I'm staying with the MNQ. Again, the best time to trade the ES really is what I've experienced more the overnight market. US overnight doesn't move as erratic. I mean, there's erratic moves, but you're trading more of momentum trades. So not really enough momentum here. Barely touched the 36.2 retracement. Let's see if it's going to continue and going further over retracement, at least down to these levels here. What you see here is more of, this is the RTH VWAP right here. This is the ETH VWAP. So right now price, so you can see there's a gap between the two, and the price is currently above both each of those two VWAPs. So this may pull back all the way maybe down here somewhere and then pull back up. That's what I'm speculating. So we want to see a good high momentum bar, strong momentum bar to the upside. If that is, then it's basically a pullback here, the retrace, then maybe we can get this up to maybe up to here. So there, let me see.
Order submitted.
let's wait for a pullback here, maybe the 50% retracement or 61.8, but we'll see if it does jump off this 38.20. Looks like it will. Right now, to the plus one deviation. Let me try to get back to plus two. Let's see. Or will it pull back to the 50% or 50% or 61.8 retracement zone?
Finally got the 50 points saved. I just need a bit more than that. Look at this, I was down as much as what? I just had to be patient. Exact 27 days, so there's no conditions that can offer. Which would be going by a little bit more. And this whole thing is $400. $400 trade right there. Just keep putting back, again, I'm down on 27.86, which I'll take. So, let me see if there's a setup here, yes. That is a beautiful trade under the S. So, give me trade here again. I'm again this right now.
Again, that was a $400 trade. Sorry, my microphone was way up there. But anyways, that was a $400 trade. Got back most of my losses there. So I'm at 20, well, to be exact, I'm down 27 bucks, which is close to break even. So I'll take that. Let's see if I can scalp here on ES.
Order submitted.
So this is going down. I should have got more points here, but that's fine. I'll take where I'm at right now, considering that I was down 400 and I made it up mostly on that one last trade. So let's see if we can get a pullback. Hopefully we can get another 200. I'll be happy with that. So we're down here at the minus two deviation, and it should have been the play. Again, as you can see here, we were up here at the plus two deviation. We've now oscillated back all the way down to the minus two. And let's see if it's going to get up to here and come back down. We can take advantage of that. Just to be patient again. Again, I should not have taken all these losses, but I'd be up right now. But like I said, fortunate to have where I'm at right now. So if I'm looking here at the Fibonacci's, it totally just reversed based on this. Started off here, came back down here. Let me see. Right there. And it came back up. Got another Fibonacci wave. Basically right here. And we reached another one there. So we're pulling back here. Let's see if we can come back here and come back down. That's almost got V2 on this.
Order filled. Stop filled.
And that's why I don't trade that ES. That ES is really, you know what? You need to have a big stop, well, even though it says 8.
Order submitted.
Do this again on ES.
Order filled. Order submitted.
So they're gonna be last trade right here. I'm down $23 even, so.
Order canceled.
Order submitted.
Order canceled. Order submitted. Order canceled.
Well, I'm gonna do is end it. Extended my trade room here. So that said, again, I'm pretty much break even. I'm down 27 bucks. Well, here it's basically 1980, but all in all, I'm down 27 or 23. Profit is around $33.50. With the commissions, it's down minus 23. Talk to you guys on Wednesday. Take care and God bless. Bye-bye.